Perfect.
How fares the hunt, my friend? Thank you. May you wander. How fares the hunt, my friend? May you wander in wisdom. How fares the hunt, my friend? May you... How fares the hunt, my friend? May you... How fares the hunt, my friend? May you wander in wisdom. How fares the hunt, my friend? May you... How fares the hunt, my friend? May you...
In the darkness of the woods, you spot a man overlooking a cage that holds creatures crept from a nightmare. Despite the all too...
Go on. Step in from the shadows. Let's have a look. There is much weakness in the...
He eyes you.
I stand...
He sighs.
The roads are rather dusty today. Aren't they gone because...
He pour...
To your... I am Jehan. Above... How regret... Are you... Very well. How fares the hunt, my friend?
He smiles brightly and pulls you in for a short, if warm, embrace.
You've done me proud, Godwoken. Prouder than you could ever realize. I know how twisted the paths can get. How much more alluring the sunny glade than the rock-strewn hollows. But you know it's the darkest roads that lead to light. It will be my honor to teach you. The nature of my lesson, though, might be somewhat different from what you expect. I can deepen your bond with the Source, but you must realize that this bond comes at a cost. All life, after all, sustains itself by consumption. Like the grass feeds the herd, and the herd feeds the hunter, so you must feed, for instance, on these.
He waves a hand to the cage in demonstration.
The very same. For the sum of source that flows through their festering flesh is more than enough to expand the sum that is yours. Through demise, a chance of divinity. Are you ready? Then let us begin.
Jahan's incantations befog your mind. All of you is thumping blood, pumping, pumping, pumping. Then, all you hear, then all that is screaming. From the cage to you, their blood in your ears, screaming. Silence.
That is all. Their sons have set to serve a greater dawn. The world awaits your true awakening. You were very powerful already. A master of the source. But I did not let this burst of power go to waste. It lies condensed on parchment for you to read and learn.
He hands you a book, hot to the touch, a sparkle with source.
My pleasure. And now that the lesson has ended, there is one more matter I would like to discuss. Offer you a chance to deepen our alliance. You see, the demon that you killed, the Advocate, he had a master. You might say the Advocate compared to his master like the pussycat compares to the tiger. It is the tiger I am truly hunting. Now, don't you worry. I have no intention of sending you after this archdemon. There are few enough Godwoken as it stands for me to force them into any real danger. The one thing I would like you to do for me, though, is to return through the mist to the Isle of Blood and uncover there his name. A demon's true name is its weakness, which is why it basks in being known by a thousand different aspects of its inmost self. But such dark magic was wrought upon Blood Moon Island that its inmost self must have been there in its true guise, exposed so that it could wreak ultimate havoc. That is when its name must have been spoken. And when spoken, heard, over there, among the blood, in the darkness of the ruins, amid the mangled dead, his name still rings, however faint. For once spoken, the echo of a demon's name never truly fades. Return to the island, Godwoken, and listen.
The statue is a striking sight, a sizzling blue totem on a blood-red aisle. Even stranger, a shard of polished iron peeks from under the statue's base. There's something hidden beneath this massive sculpture. Even a triple-sized troll couldn't make the statue budge. Whatever the stone figure guards remains a mystery, at least for now.
Something delicious.
Way.
Close, watching, but not for you, for Master.
What's that smell?
Something delicious.
Where?
Close, watching, but not for you, for Master.
What's that smell?
Something delicious.
Where?
Close, watching, but not for you, for Master.
Reaper for me. Thank you. Odd old thing, isn't it?
The Great Forge is black with a soot of ancient work. Inside is a casting for an ornate handle, flecked with glittering bits of silver.
Volumes, a trove of history and knowledge. What's this? I found something.
The transparent artifact glimmers of its own accord, as if conducting light from another world, another plane of living. As your hand nears it, it shivers and speaks. You listen closely, but while you think you've heard similar utterances in the past, you cannot make sense of its words.
Aman falan revel. Amadi ovalucio di amederita tamorius.
The object repeats its indecipherable twaddle. You can glean no more from it.
Not just another oddity, it would seem. It spoke to me.
I can feel my source powers draining at the merest touch.
Another pyramid.
The is truly How a very material useful. Of the void.
A war owl swoops down from the sky and delivers a message for the Red Prince. Red Prince, I am the one who has been hunting you, but you cling to life all too tenaciously. We must speak of the reason for your expulsion from the ancient empire, and we must speak of the Red Princess. Find me on the Nameless Isle at the Temple of Zor Stissa. In the presence of the goddess, let war and shadow meet.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you? My friend, I consider it my scholarly duty to know what I can of all that lives and unlives. Surely you, of all people, understand the quest for knowledge. What else can I do you for? A potion? A scroll? Another dose of my ineffable charm?
The object quivers as Tarquin nears it and hums a response. Connected as one, the past and present slain. Absolution and redemption await the one whose sins are many.
Oh, very good. Very, very, very good. This, my friend, is the key. Give me some time, and every deity in existence will tremble at the sight of you.
He holds out his hand, expectantly.
Lovely. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must work.
Tarquin turns away, but continues to mutter excitedly, almost religiously, about anathema.
Aren't you supposed to be off learning how to become the divine and whatnot?
Her eyes flash with something. Anger, perhaps, or fear.
But never mind. We'd better focus on the task at hand.
She looks straight ahead, ignoring you.
Well, aren't you industrious? It seems all the riffraff's back aboard as well. Ready to set sail when you are, Your Holiness.
In a long time.
A fine vessel you have here, sorcerer. I hope you'll use it to get us far away from this place. Freedom can't come soon enough. Have you made any progress with my request, dear? Have you found that tablet? Excellent. Why, I knew I could rely on you. That is all for now, darling. My thanks. Here, a little token for all your efforts so far. Now, I'd better study this tablet for a while. I'm sure it could teach even me a thing or two.
These are lone wolves. Let me do the talking.
Company. Wonder how they made it through.
The grim-faced guard raises his weapon as you approach, then stops short and quickly bows respectfully.
You fain been mazed, as I live and breathe. Didn't think we'd be seeing you again so soon, sir. He is. He'd be glad to see you, too. Glad as roost gets, anyway. He's hoping you'll bring friends.
He winks at you so hard and so theatrically.
Roost's upstairs in the big house there, sir. He's waiting for you. Reckon he's as eager to hear how you've been getting on as the rest of us.
Been here longer than normal.
Place makes a good base.
Is that right?
We got money now.
Your living is nothing if you're unhappy.
Never knew you to be sentimental.
Logical, not sentimental. Unhappy people are sloppy, unreliable.
Maybe that's why I ain't landed a mark in a while. I'm unhappy.
How many of them can there be?
enough to keep us in drink. All right.
Careful now. That's a trap.
Maybe that's why I ain't landed a mark in a while. I'm unhappy. Or maybe I'm just horny.
Logical, not sentimental. Unhappy people are sloppy, unreliable.
Maybe that's why I ain't landed a mark in a while.
That's all I need to know. Memories.
A massive man looms over a small elf, his hair a tangle of matted knots. Scars upon scars cross every inch of visible flesh, from his hands to his gnarled face. He slurps something into his mouth, thoughtfully chews for a moment, then spits it on the ground, where it lands with a sickly splat.
It don't work. For me, anyway. You try.
He offers her something round and slippery, like a wet, white marble in the palm of his hand.
I do not defile the dead.
And you an elf?
We eat flesh to honor it, not to steal the secrets of the dead.
Secrets, secrets, they're no fun. Hurt someone.
Ifan clears his throat. Roost turns his face to you both and roughly wrenches the elf's jaw towards you as well.
Well, look at that, elf. The silver claw is back. Ifan, old boy, you're losing your bloody touch. Your mark, Alexander, still draws breath. And my sources tell me he's headed somewhere called the Nameless Isle. I'll be setting sail there myself any day now to take him out. Your failure has put the reputation of all wolves at stake. But I suppose I might be swayed to forgiveness by the other little godwoken morsels you've brought me.
Stay away from the godwoken roost. They're mine.
Roost looks around shiftily and pats his pockets, but ignores your question.
Mouthy ones, aren't they, Ben Mezd? Must have been a long journey here.
Roost bursts into laughter, great peals of it racking his frame. Then, too quickly, he sobers completely and pins Ifan with a viperish gaze.
We've had good times, Ben Mezd. We've had bad times. But this is the best time of all. You, just dancing a contract right into my lap. What else are friends for?
Roost moves to lunge at you, but Ifan is quicker. With two steps and three stabs, he slows Roost down just long enough for you to draw your weapon. Right where I want you.
Hurts, doesn't it?
Prepare yourself.
Thank you. take you.
The Divine Order? What the devil? The contract seems to predate Alexander's ascension, too.
I know you come. I know you do. I know I only have to wait. Do we return now? To the others? My people wait for me nearby. Yes. Yes, thank you. I see you so clearly. I see the goodness in you. Let's go! Freedom. It is good to... Thank you.
I'm ready!
I'll yield to none. Thank you.
Hurts, doesn't it?
Ah! Thank you. Thank you.
The Fletcher trembles before the mass of...
They're dead. That means I can leave. What I do best, making bows and arrows. Roost was a fan of my work and, well, he forced me to work for him. Gods, this makes a ship. A bit of sea air could be just what I need to relax. Decide what comes next.
He reaches for your hand and shakes it.
It's a deal. Must be moored off the Driftwood Harbor, right? I'll meet you there. Thank you.
That looks dangerous, but maybe I can disarm it.
We continue. We go on.
My baby, my girl, there you are.
Heal your wounds.
Mother!
We need you standing.
My dearest friend, the one who saves me.
You give us everything.
Thank you for helping me. Without you, I am already dead.
You save us all. My girl is back. Our Sion is back.
I know what you need, and I can help you. We can help you.
She crouches down, placing a hand on the earthen ground.
Can you hear them? Their roots stretch beneath us, even now. Yes, they are cut down, destroyed and defiled. But our roots run deeper than any know. Our roots cross the world many times over. I will link you. You will hear them. They will feed you. Increase the source in you. Increase the power.
She leans toward you, her veiled eyes directed toward the ground. The slightest of smiles plays over her lips, then vanishes.
A space inside you clears. You have room for more source. You have room for more everything. Hold your hand to the ground. I hold my hand over yours.
We need you standing.
We breathe together. We call the spirit of the trees to us. Close your eyes. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and inhale.
With each in-breath, the voices flutter in, whispers at first, then gentle murmurs like water over rocks. The wind of the voices enters you as you and Sahela breathe together. It travels down your throat, into your belly, around your heart. Suddenly, your blood runs icy cold, then warms again. The wind seems to search you for space it can inhabit, but it is expelled with your next outbreath.
Ah, you are. You are replete. You open yourself to a great deal of source already. There is no space for us. There is little more to do then. I must go, but take this. Perhaps it helps you on your journey. You feel my gratitude in it. You feel my thanks.
I give you something too. A thanks.
Take this spear. It destroys evil. It helps you. You help us more than you know. We make arrangements. We travel soon. I must meet someone who can help us. I say no more than this. But I do wish you good luck. And perhaps we meet again someday.
And if you need, I am fine.
So? Ready to set sail when you are, Your Holiness. Fantastic. Now, on to the interesting part.
After many adventures, the party finally reached the place where Godwoken go to become divine. But more surprises and difficult choices awaited.
Here we are, the Nameless Isle. And here I thought Malady was unimaginative. Still, it's what's on the inside that counts, isn't that right? And this is the place you're meant to become a god. I can't help but wonder exactly what you intend to do with such a power. I have no doubt about that, but do remember, you can do what's good for you, too. All things in balance, you know. You'll want to hurry now. Divinity is waiting, after all. I'm hardly an expert on the matter, but I'm smart enough to put two and two together. Where there is an ocean of source, there is a well for drawing from it. To rise to divinity, you probably need to take a gulp. Though I'm sure it won't be that simple. Excellent question. Normally, this place ought only to be known to Godwoken, but judging by the ships burning in the bay, there's been a breach, let's call it. Regardless of who's on the island, all that matters is who ascends. Make sure that's you. The strongest will survive and ascend.
Tread carefully, my dear. Those are black ring banners that I spy on the shore.
I've got sword fighters, mages, archers, all willing to fight by your side if the price is right. Whatever type of companion you need, I can. You can put a price on the warriors I have for hire, but you can't put a price on the glory they'll win you. No one ever regretted having extra help in a fight. Guarantee you that. Allies for hire.
I studied the tablet that you so generously provided. It showed me everything I need to know about creating a functional Swornbreaker. Once I have that, I'll be free of the Covenant. And free to spend the rest of my days with Mahali. See those structures further inland? Remarkably like those from the caverns of the Black Pits, aren't they? Should you discover the parts needed for a Swornbreaker, please bring them to me. I'll make it worth your while. Also, you will likely encounter sworn followers of the God King on that island, I suspect. I would avoid combat if possible. Death can be less than final for them, if the God King wills it.
Almira doesn't respond right away. Instead, she turns and gazes intently at the island. After a long...
I sense a familiar presence. The Sallow Man. Yes. He's there somewhere. Likely commanding Black Ring forces. You should seek him out. He's a foul creature, but not opposed to cutting a deal. Beware his underlings, though. If they challenge your presence, pose as a thrall of mine, and you should gain safe passage. My name should still command respect among them.
Quite a journey I've found myself on with you. Is this where it ends, I wonder?
Dangers indeed. You can almost hear the sounds of battle when the wind shifts correctly. And where there's battle, there's bound to be mercenaries.
Thank you. let you down. No one's ever regretted having extra help in a fight. I'll guarantee you that.
Glehu Duma, the words of the Lone Wolves. No doubt my former comrades will have them in their employ. Speak their words, and you might pass. Speak their words, and you might pass. Consider it a token of my thanks for the assistance in retrieving Anathema. My efforts continue. I must admit it's quite an intricate piece to work with, even for someone like myself. I remain confident of success, though.